Greetings everyone, and welcome back to the Den. I am Misal Dragon. Now before we begin, I have to say that I didn't know that this organization and my employers had this reputation and was against the LGBT plus community. Had I known that before applying to be a bell ringer, I wouldn't have applied at all. Since I am panromantic and asexual, I can't knowingly support an organization who would treat a community, the community, like that. Lastly, I worked for them in 2017, so things may have changed while I was working there. Now, let's start with what it was like working for them as a bell ringer. Let's start with some papers I got after being hired and go through them with small comments from me as I read them. Thank you again for allowing the organization to place bell ringers and kettles at your location. Our 2017 Red Kettle campaign is from November 10th through December 23rd. If you are wondering, we got Thanksgiving off, but not the day before. We hope to have bell ringers at your store from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. or during normal business hours Monday through Saturday. In the state I live, the minimum wage is $7.50. Guess how much I got an hour? Well, I'm not allowed to say, but you can probably guess that I wasn't paid more than was necessary, since this was a charity and they wanted more money to go people in need. Also where I live, 30 minutes is the minimum for lunch break. We got 15-minute breaks and we're allowed to take 2 of those. Please call me if our bell ringers are impeding your customers in any way. We had to ring bells. We were impeding on people's hearing. Each paid or volunteer bell ringer has been given expectations and guidelines to follow and how to appropriately conduct themselves while at your store. Yeah, and we'll get to those later. It will be helpful if you allow the bell ringer to store the kettle equipment in a designated area while they are on break or at lunch. At the conclusion of each day, a driver will come pick up the kettle and replace it with a new one. And it isn't always at 8. Sometimes traffic isn't good and you gotta wait with the kettle till the driver gets there. If possible, we would like the bell ringer to call our office from your store telephone when they report for work. Despite how early you call, you'll be clocked in at 9 and clocked out at 8 no matter how long it takes for the driver to get there. This will ensure that someone is covered at your store. We only have 40 ringing days. Therefore, a bell ringer will be at your store if we have personnel. The key word there is if. Thank you very much for your support. And that is what was sent to the managers or store owners in 2017. Next is the list of requirements bell ringers had to go by. Number 1. Always have a pleasant attitude. Remember, you are representing the spirit of Christmas and the organization. Smile, and be sure to say thank you. Ah yes, I am the spirit of Christmas present. When do I get to die? 2. Use common sense at all times. They never defined common sense, and some people don't know what common sense is to these people. Number 3. Understand we don't have the right to stand our kettles at any store. We are there because we're invited to be. So, be gracious and kind in your dealings with and about the store and management. Invited? You asked permission if the earlier note is anything to go by. The last part also makes it sound like a drug deal. Number 4. Be clean and presentable and dressed in weather appropriate organization branded attire. They actually have a dress code? Black pants, black shoes, white shirts, no logos, or anything that might make people think you have money. Number 5. Be gracious, even with those who choose not to give. We don't ask people to put money in the kettle. We just make it easy and fun for them to do so. Maybe if they're a kid. As an adult, I can say it's not easy, nor is it fun. Buying stuff from individuals and helping them in their day-to-day life is more fun and easy because you help someone else and get something in return. Number 6. Always stand at your kettle. No sitting unless you have a doctor's note. If you don't know how hard this is, then I recommend you stand in one place for an hour and just in that one place. If you get tired, then you can actually sit down, but bell ringers aren't supposed to do this. Number 7. Do not use your mobile phone unless you are on break or it's an emergency. And how am I supposed to know when it's time for my break when I'm not supposed to check the time? In case you're saying take the break when you want, you have a specific time you're supposed to take breaks, not whenever you want to take your 2 15-minute breaks. Number 8. Never smoke or eat near the kettle. Understandable. Have a day. Number 9. Work alone unless you are part of a group to have permission to stand the kettle together. Distracted bell ringers miss an opportunity to make eye contact and be friendly. And this is why bell ringers stare at you. They have to make eye contact. Number 10. Wish people a Merry Christmas. No matter the religion, even if you know they aren't religious. Number 11. Keep a cheat sheet handy with kettle-appropriate messages. A. Thank you for your donation to help people in need this Christmas and all year long. B. Your donation to the organization stays in this community to help our neighbors. C. If you'd like more information about the organization, please find us online at www.redacted.org. Org. Used for evil. For evidence, see the Cartoon Network show Villainous. A group of villains sell weapons to help other villains and they use .org. Number 12. Limit your conversations to kettle-related topics. Please don't discuss organization policy, positions, or theology. Questions of this nature should be referred to the Divisional Public Relations Director. Oh yeah, keep those bell ringers in line. No fun allowed. Most of all, the organization is grateful for your service. Well, it'd be nice to get a thank you, even if it's not a big one, but, you know, that's just too human and pleasant for the organization like yours to do. Right? After all, this is a Christian organization. Saying thank you shouldn't be that hard. If you can't tell, I didn't like working for the organization, but that doesn't mean it was all bad. The people who put money in the kettle were really nice. Someone even bought me noise-dampening earbuds. I wasn't allowed to use them, unfortunately, but there were a lot of people like that who I got to meet because of that job, and I'm really glad I met them. Well, that's all I need to say. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, leave a like, and if you didn't, then please tell me why in the comments so I may improve. Have a pleasant rest of your day. So long!